Today, we are going to be taking a low-level scenic flight around the Freycinet Peninsula of Tasmania. I am really excited for this flight, as there is some fantastic rocky cliffs and beautiful beaches to see along the way. Okay, let's go flying. After departing from Friendly Beaches Airfield, we will head south, following the coastline at a low altitude down the Freycinet Peninsula. We will then fly around Schoeten Island, and then head back north along the western side of the peninsula, passing Wineglass Bay, Coles Bay, and then back to Friendly Beaches Airfield.
Center, Cubcrafters Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra is type Cubcrafters CC 19 1 miles east of Yankee Foxtrot Romeo, India 800 feet. Request flight following.
Cubcrafters Alpha Sierra X-ray Golf Sierra Melbourne Center. Crosswalk 7542.
Crosswalk 7542 Cubcrafters X-ray Golf Sierra. Roger, Cubcrafters X-ray Golf Sierra.
We can start to see some nice cliff faces and rock formations coming up. I will try to stay low, so we can get a great view as we fly by. That little rock there is called boot rock. Those rocks in the water ahead are called the nuggets. I think there should also be a lighthouse on the right, but it doesn't seem to be included in the Microsoft Flight Simulator scenery. That is Mount Amos, and the famous Wineglass Bay over in the distance. But don't worry, we'll get a much better view of Wineglass Bay later, on our way back. The little rocks we see in the water have names. This next one is called Lulof Rock. We also missed another one before called Lemon Rock. Lemon Rock actually has some historical significance, as it used to have a small lighthouse on top, but it was discontinued in 1971 due to the difficulty in accessing it. The rocky outcrop straight ahead of us is called Gates Bluff. Here is a better view of Gates Bluff. The natural landscape is so beautiful in this area. Look how high the cliffs are getting now. Okay, we are now heading towards Schoeten Island. We will fly around it and then start our return journey back to the airfield. Schoeten Island is considered one of the most pristine environments on the Freycinet Peninsula. It is popular with campers and snorkelers, and the only way to get there is by private boat or a long swim if you are brave enough. If you would like an extra bit of trivia, the island was named by Abel Tasman in 1642. He named it after Juist Schouten, who was a council member of the Dutch East India Trading Company. Over on the right, that little bay is called Hen and Chicken Bay. It's a funny name. I'm not sure if it looks like a chicken or not. Wow! Look at those incredible cliffs! They almost look like waterfalls. Below us is Morley's Beach. It is one of the best beaches on Schoeten Island with its pristine white sands. Okay, it is time to say goodbye to Schoeten Island. We will now head back up the western coast of the peninsula and see what else we can find. That is Passage Beach on the right. And just ahead is Brian's Beach. There are so many stunning white sandy beaches in this area. Below us is Cook's Beach. It is one of the most popular camping destinations on the Freycinet Peninsula. We are now approaching Wineglass Bay again. I will gain some altitude so we can get a better bird's eye view. The long beach on the western side is called Hazards Beach. Wineglass Bay is just across on the east side. It is no doubt one of the most famous and most photographed beaches in Tasmania. There you go. That is a pretty good view. As we start our descent, we will be heading over Coles Bay. Coles Bay is the main settlement and entrance point for visitors to the Freycinet area. That is Coles Bay below us. Alright, we will now head back to Friendly Beaches Airfield. We have just over 5 miles to run. Before we land, let me take this opportunity to thank you for flying with us today. I really hope you enjoyed our scenic flight around the Freycinet Peninsula. There's the runway. Let's turn for final. I really enjoyed that flight. I hope you did too. See you in the next one.